So we went through a circuit where we applied Ohm's law, calculating voltage and current, and we were given the resistance, and that's fine. There was a gentleman then, Gustav Robert Kirchhoff, who looked at what Ohm did, and he added his interpretation to some of the circuit analysis that we're talking about today. So what he said was, let's go back to our circuit. We had that three-resistor circuit. Let me come down here. And we had 12 volts, we had 1k ohm, we had 2k ohm, and we had 3k ohm. And as we remember, we had across here, we had 2 volts because we had 2 milliamps going through the circuit. Something you may notice that I do is I do identify polarities when I draw my circuits. Why? Because when current enters a component, a passive component like a resistor, there is a plus side, a high side, and a low side to it. So identifying the high sides and low sides becomes helpful in some other circuit types of calculations we do. So in this case here, let's just go back to the numbers we had. We had 2 volts across here. We had 4 volts across here. And we had here, we had 6 volts. Now, what Kirchhoff said was, first of all, you need a closed loop so that we have current flowing. And in a closed loop circuit, we can note that the sum of the voltages around the loop equals zero. So let me just use some abbreviated terminology. The sum, sigma, of the V drops around the closed loop equals zero. So let's see if that's true. Well, here we have R1, the voltage across R1, it was 2 volts. And if I'm following the current through, so I would say plus, okay, plus the voltage here, which was 4 volts, plus the voltage here, which is 6 volts, minus the voltage here, which was 12 volts, equals to zero. Does that add up? So this is 6, 4, 10 is 12 volts equals, other sign, reverse the sign, 12 volts. Of course, they're equal, and that's what an equation is. So this is an interesting situation with circuits that you can figure out then, knowing using Ohm's law to maybe find a current, what the voltages are at a certain point in a particular circuit. So let's look at this. Let's look at this again. I'm going to give you another circuit, and we'll go around the circuit using this Kirchhoff law of voltages. KVL is sometimes how we abbreviate that. And we'll analyze the voltage drops around the circuit and see where we stand. So we talked about Ohm, George Simon. We've talked about Kirchhoff, Gustav Robert Kirchhoff. And I want to recall that voltage equals current times resistance from Mr. Ohm. And the sum of the voltage drops around a closed loop circuit where current is flowing is equal to zero, also known as Kirchhoff's voltage laws. So let's take an example of Kirchhoff's voltage laws where we may have to do a little bit of work. So I'm going to use a circuit that's, let's say, a resistor like this. And I'm going to introduce a device called a diode and another resistor in the circuit. Again, I want a reference point, which is my ground. Let's use 12 volts again. That's fine. Plus is minus here. This is going to be plus minus. This will be plus minus as the current goes around the circuit. Plus minus. The current will go this way in the circuit. I'm showing that as I. Let's try 4,000 ohms for this one. 5,000 ohms for this one. Now, this device, which may be new to you, maybe not, but is a diode. And a diode is two semiconductor pieces of material, P and N junction generally. And the nature of the energy levels in the two materials is such that It's as if you had a very small reverse biased battery in this diode, like this, okay? And that particular battery is fighting this flow. And if it's a silicon battery, if it's a silicon diode, that battery voltage is 0.7 volts. So you'll come into this kind of configuration in your later design courses, but right now, let's just say there's a 0.7 volt drop across a diode when current flows through it. Okay, so let's use Kirchhoff's voltage laws. This is, just gonna go back here, this is resistor one. This is resistor two, this is diode one, this is our source voltage. So if we look at this, the voltage, he said the sum of the voltages around a closed loop is equal to zero. So we should have the voltage from resistor one plus the 0.7, remember plus, minus, minus, okay? Plus the 0.7 volts, plus the voltage across, the voltage drop across resistor two, minus the 12 volts, will equal zero. Actually, you know what? I'm just going to change the numbers just for calculation purposes. That's okay, it's not a big deal. What we'll do is we're going to change this to, let me just use 7 volts, and it'll make the math a little easier. So this is a 7 volt source now. So again, VR1 diode drop, VR2 minus the source voltage, 7 volts equals zero. Let's just collect terms. So here we have VR1, VR2, and on the other side, that'll be plus 7 minus 0.7, 6.3 volts. Okay, what is I in this circuit? Back to Ohm's law, I is equal to V over R. In this case here, we have 6.3 volts. And the total resistance is 4K plus 5K, which is 9,000 ohms. So anybody? 0.7 volts, correct? Is my math good? Looks pretty good there. So we have 0.7 volts. I'm sorry, you didn't correct me. It's 0.7, we're talking about current. 0.7 amps, 700 milliamps, okay? 0.7 milliamps, okay, 0.7 milliamps. All right, reasonable. So that's 0.7 times 10 to the minus 3. That's good. So now we have a current flow. So, all right, so according to Kirchhoff, then we have this voltage, which happens to be I times R1, plus the 0.7, plus the I times R2, okay? It was equal to 7 volts here. And so I times R1 plus R2 is equal to 6.3 volts, as we had there. And if you do this math, which we did over there, we came up to 0.7 milliamps. So what is the voltage here at this particular point? Let's solve this particular equation here. So the voltage is I times R1. R1 is 0.7 times that, so it should be 2.8 volts. R2 should be 5 times 0.7, which is 3.5 volts. Okay. And does that equal 6.3? Let's see. 2.8, 5, 6.3 volts. So Kirchhoff is correct. The sum of the voltage drops, the 2.8, the 0.7 and the 3.5 minus the 7 equals zero, or if we rearrange the equation, we now have our numbers. So what's the significance of all that? Well, let's say that you did want to know at this point, if I put a voltmeter here, what is that voltage? Well, let's see, we dropped 2.8 volts here. So that means 7 minus 2.8, which is 4.2 volts. You will come across a number of circuits which will have some kind of configuration here where you have a resistance, you have a voltage drop due to a semiconductor device, and you'll have another resistor, and you need to figure out what is the voltage at that particular point, or what is the current through that particular resistor in this particular circuit. Kirchhoff is your solution to that.